the brewmaster here. And that gets picked up by J.O., who is normally their safe lane carry, I believe. Monkeys Forever is their mid laner, obviously, with the Templar Assassin. So we'll get right into this game here. Once again, this is a best of five between Archon and DC in the BTS series. This is the grand final of BTS series America's number three. Just waiting for Theban and Fluff and Stuff to pick up their two heroes here.
5 seconds, Morty. It'll be fine.
And we will jump right into this game. See plenty of wards coming out. Didn't see a smoke purchase instantly. Sometimes you see the Chen pick up a nice early smoke to go for, you know, a nice gank on the offlaner. We'll see the Tusk pick it up instead. So we have Aoi 2000 playing this Bounty Hunter. As I mentioned earlier, we see resolution on this Puck. We'll see 1437 on this Witch Doctor. We see Mason playing instead of Yawar, actually, on this Weaver for Digital Chaos. And then in the base, we have Bulba on this Nature's Prophet. Somewhere here, we see J.O. on this Brewmaster.
Don't look now, but battle's about to start.
We'll see Whitebeard playing this Tusk. And we have Monkeys Forever on the Templar Assassin. And playing in the safe lane up against this Nature's Prophet, who is starting to run towards the top lane. As you'd expect. Well, you wouldn't really expect that. But the Weaver can play the off lane a lot easier. And they're dodging the Legion Commander matchup here. Resolution standing on top of the Ruin. He'll secure that for himself. And Monkeys Forever will take the top Ruin. Easy enough. Aoi will show himself in the bottom, get a little bit of info on this Muhoda Legion Commander, which they were pretty much expecting to be in the safe lane to deal with this Nature's Prophet in the off lane. So they kind of mind gamed him there and sent Bulba up to the top lane to go up against J.O. and Whitebeard here. Bulba will spot out this Tusk with his Treants, and then he'll send him up to help deal with J.O. Tusk just missed the shard there, almost locked in Bulba with the Brewmaster. Might have been the death of Brewmaster here as he got fairly low. He will have to pop his salve. We'll see Aoi in the mid here, helping to deal with this Chen that rotated in to help Monkeys Forever. In the bottom, we see Muhoda going up against 1437 and Mason on this Weaver. Level 2 now up for the Templar Assassin, so with her side blades and refraction, this Puck will have a little bit more difficult time. I imagine we'll see Aoi rotating through the mid quite often to keep the harass up. And we'll see Theban drop a little bit here. So checking throughout the map, we actually see the Legion Commander 5 last hits. To the 4 of the Weaver. Pretty much all of the carries are tied up. Our carries, mid laners, off laners are all tied up at either 5 or 4 last hits, which is something you always like to see, but we're only a minute and a half in. So everybody doing, you know, fairly decently right now. Don't see a Quelling Blade up on this Legion Commander. We'll see if she wants to work towards an Iron Talon to help her jungle a little bit here. We do see the Quelling Blade on the Brewmaster. I imagine that'll be turned into an Iron Talon fairly shortly here. See a Ring of Protection up on Nature's Prophet. We'll see what Bulba wants to turn that into. Classic Theban being called out by Monkeys Forever here. So we see this Templar Assassin has a Wraith Band up. Fairy Fire has a Sentry Ward. to help deal with this Alley 2000 bounty hunter who will be rotating in. Looks like both the teams are ready to go, and we will jump right back into this game. So we see Ali trailing Fluff and Stuff here as they both rotate over to the bottom lane. We'll actually see Tusk start to walk his way over, handed his smoke off to the Chen to help with the early gank. Got it. See Chen grab another Wildwing Ripper, looking to employ that tornado to get as much harassment onto the side of Digital Chaos as possible. You know, last hits wise, everybody's still doing fairly decently, minus the Puck, who's slightly fallen off behind Monkeys Forever here, down to 6 last hits compared to the 12 of Puck. Aoi will rotate in, just gets a single hit off here. Drops down a sentry to counter out any sort of sentry that Monkeys Forever drops, but he's all out. Fluff will now work his way back over to the mid to help out Monkeys Forever. Duels or brawls. We see the Wildwing Ripper up for the Chen in the bottom lane here, providing the tornado harassment onto Mason and 1437, just trying to keep them back as far as possible. Resolution down to just 160 HP, has his bottle arriving right now though, so he'll be able to bottle back up and be just fine momentarily. Regen Ruin up on the top, we'll see who actually can work their way over there and grab that. See Aoi start to rotate back in here. Fraction charges just went down, this might be a kill on to the Templar Assassin here. She pops the Fairy Fire, not enough damage, or not enough health. One last right click from the Puck will finish this off. First Blood going the way of Resolution. 300 gold up. 300 gold going towards Resolution there, and he finds the perfect ruin in the mid, or in the top lane, grabs that. Regeneration has his boots delivered. He's off to a great start against this Templar Assassin now. A little bit behind in the last hits, but now, you know, a little over half a level ahead. See Aoi rotating back towards the bottom here, trying to help out Mason and 1437. Have a bit of an engagement on the Legion Commander, but nothing for the Coconut to bounce into. We'll see Fluff rotate in on this Chen with the Centaur ready to go. Overwhelming odds comes out on Theban. That'll be the death of 1437 as Mason's Weaver just heads his way out. Arcane Ruin up on this Aoi Bounty Hunter, but doesn't have the Shriek and Toss yet, so won't get too much use out of that. Looks like he will not crack level 3 before he can put that to use. We'll see the Witch Doctor rotate up to the top to help out Bulba, who's having a really good time up against the Brewmaster here. 22 last hits, the 23. But they'd probably like to shut down the Brew a little bit harder, so they'll provide a little more harassment up towards the top. Resolution has his Boots of Speed, Gloves of Haste comes up for him. Should just be working towards Power Treads, I don't imagine he'll get the Midas. Weaver, Belt of Strength, Boots of Speed, just be working towards Power Treads as well. Phase Boots we see come out for Bulba, gets a nice surround from the trees, but Jo does have that Quailing Blade and will just chew his way right out. 1437 and Bulba will now work through. Just a stack of creeps on the side here. See Aoi harassing up monkeys forever as much as possible. Wolva TP down to try to help out this Weaver, but ends up the Weaver going down even with the Nature's Wrath coming out. Gets Whitebeard and Muhoda down to about half HP. Both press the attacks, able to heal back up just fine. The seeds are fortunate. Bit of an engagement onto Jao here. Resolution will drop the Dream Coil. Not able to finish him off before he can get the split. This will be the death of 1437 for sure. DD up on Resolution. Should be able to pick off this Brewmaster. As soon as the Brew split ends here, he'll orb forward to make sure he's in a nice position. Won't actually follow the orb. He'll let Aoi finish him off. Has a shuriken and one last hit. Actually misses the first attack. Second attack will finish him off though. Mason and White and Bulba trying to chase down Muhoda and Whitebeard here. Mason will Shikuchi forwards, but the nice shards come out and blocks him. See Fluff clashing with Resolution and Aoi 2000 in the middle here. Nothing will come of that. We'll see the Legion Commander and the Tusk head back towards the base. Mason and Bulba will get some nice damage onto this Tier 1 in the bottom lane here. Fortification comes out for the Radiant. And we'll see Muhoda TP back in. This will be the end of the clash down here. End of the push. Muhoda just short of that duel. Now has the duel up. If they can get a stun onto Mason and Muhoda can get there in time, they'll be able to kill Mason, but it's going to be quite difficult without the Blink Dagger. Weaver is one slipper hero. See, they actually give 1437 a little bit of solo farm in this top lane, trying to get his level 6 up as soon as possible. Monkeys Forever has an Invis Rune bottled up. Resolution won't really be able to do much to him. We'll see Mason head back up towards the top here. Level 6 is up for 1437. It should be a nice easy kill onto the Brewmaster, and it is with Nature's Wrath rolling through. Bull will look to turn this into a push on this top lane, I'd imagine. Treant's not up for another 13 seconds, however. Have to delay this a little bit. Resolution getting sharded up, trapped up by Monkeys Forever, and Whitebeard will orb away. Pops the Fairy Fire, trying to run as fast as possible here. Drops the Dream Coil to delay things as much as possible. Shards are up. He has the range. We'll see if he wants to throw them blindly here. He does throw them, and a perfect lineup on the puck there. Goes right through the middle of his body. And that'll be the death of the puck towards Whitebeard on the Tusk. Muhoda hunting for anybody he can find up top here. Dropping overwhelming odds on the top of Aoi 2000. Dealing heavy damage to him. He'll have to back up.
Dire's middle tower's under attack.
And heal a little bit. See Whitebeard and Fluff rotating through. Looks like they're coming to help out in the top lane here. We'll see the puck head back towards the mid. We'll see Bulba head down bottom to stop Jao from getting any extra damage onto this Tier 1 tower. See Fluff move forward with just a couple creep army here. He can get another Troll Trap Summoner if he wants. With a nice net, they might be able to catch 1437 or Mason and get a nice duel. Aoi calling for a kill onto the Chen here. We'll see Mason and 1437 start to walk in. Alt is ready to go for the Witch Doctor. Doesn't look like they're ready to quite drop it on him. Bulba just doing what he can to push on bottom. Create a bit of, you know, use the space that the rest of his team is creating up top, keeping three heroes of Archon distracted and busy. It's actually the Chen Skeleton Warriors dealing with this small camp here. Fluff has the dual Troll Trap, dual Dark Troll Summoners ready to go. Really just need a target to throw these nets out onto. Aoi goes invis right before that's able to happen. See 680 gold up on this Chen just short of his arcane boots. Mason, Ring of Bassy, Boots of Speed, nothing else for him yet.
Oh boy, Dire's bottom tower's getting hit.
1437 will TP down to the mid here. Drops the alt on top of Monkeys Forever. Be a nice easy kill on Monkeys Forever that will save resolution. Whitebeard will TP out underneath 1437. And Bulba as the mana for paralyzing cask, or the cooldown was just wasn't there. Mason will get a bit of a dive onto the Chen here, easily kills him up. Nuhoda won't quite be able to get the range for the duel. Looks like he already used it and it failed. Unless he actually got the bounty hunter. He might have gotten the bounty hunter, but he did not win that duel as he doesn't have any victory damage.
Dire's bottom tower is under attack.
Brewmaster sitting at 1400 gold. Looks like he's just going for a blink first. Monkeys Forever just stacking up the Ancients a little bit right now. Fluff senses Aoi in the middle of all of his creeps. Whitebeard will run in, drop the dust, and Muhoda will move in, drop the overwhelming odds to finish him off. Brew Spirit down on bottom here, resolution sent up in the air right now. We'll see if he's able to orb away. Shouldn't have any problem, he's at full health. Earth Broodling running back, not wanting to get caught out by Bulba resolution in 1437. 1437 giving chase right now here. Sees him through the woods with this nice ward. Dream Coil and Death Ward will come out. This is the death of the Brewmaster. Puck at 3-1 right now, off to a great start. We can see the Legion Commander at 75 last hits, having a decent time herself. Shadow Amulet up, just missing the Broadsword of Claymore for this Shadow Amulet. And there's the Shadow Blade completed now. See Bulba head into the Roche Pit, summon up a few Treants and look to start this. Mason heading on over. Ring of Aquila ready to go. Don't have any medallions or anything like that, but the bugs will provide, you know, a small bit of minus armor. 1437 will walk in, has the healing ready to go in case they need it. Doesn't look like they will. They actually stay out of the pit. Has his level 6, doesn't really need, you know, that many more levels. Instead, he'll stay out and do a little bit of dewarding. Starts to walk into the pit right now. Does avoid the experience to make sure that the three cores get the majority of the experience. In the meantime there, with that Roshan, they are able to finish off a top tier 1 tower. Muhoda trying to get the dual setup on Aoi, finally able to wrangle him after Whitebeard moved in with the shards and the dust to reveal Aoi. It'll be the first victory going towards Muhoda, up to 10 stolen damage now. And with that, we see about 400 gold going the way of Archon. Resolution, Blink Dagger up on him. We see Jao complete the Blink Dagger on the Brewmaster. So Blinks come out for the mid laner and the off laner of Archon at the same time here. The mid laner of DC. So we'll see who has a better, you know, surprise blink. Puck has a little bit easier kill with his blink, as he can drop that Dream Coil. It's a lot faster. And the Brewmaster can blink clap and pop the split, but it'll take him a little bit to actually kill that target, allowing DC to get members in position to help out. Bulba can just TP in if he needs to. Drums up for Bulba here. Then has an extra robe of the Magi. We'll see if he wants to turn that into something like an orchid. Smoke up from J.O. Whitebeard and the Chen creeps here, along with Fluff himself. They're moving in onto Mason. They spot out Mason. He'll pop the smoke. J.O. will blink up towards 1437. And this is largely a revealed smoke here. Legion Commander drops into the Shadow Blade. Will run away. Aoi throws a track onto the Chen here. On their way out. Mason giving chase. Resolution will actually jump in, drop the Dream Coil, instantly kill off the Chen. They're able to pick off the Whitebeard Tusk before he can TP out. Should be able to kill off the Legion Commander up on the top here. Brewmaster will actually move in, kill off 1437. Mason desperately trying to get close enough to Mohoda to finish him off. The trees worked against him along with the Chen creeps there, and the Legion Commander is able to TP home just fine. In the end, a 2-for-2. About to be a 3-for-2 if Mason doesn't run here. Templar Assassin moving back in. Chen creeps moving back in. See how greedy Mason's feeling. He'll we'll let the Brewmaster run away. Always sticking around long enough to make sure Mason gets away here. No trades across the map after that one. So we see a bit extra gold going the way of Archon, and about an extra 200 gold going their way after that fight. And a god comes out to keep this Legion Commander alive. Mason thinking about going in deep. They pop the dust. Won't catch anybody with it here. Dreamcoil comes out on to two. This will be another death of the Chen. Legion Commander pops the duel. Able to pick off Resolution. That'll be another duel going his way. Might be able to pick off Mason here unless he decides to turn and run. He'll actually re-engage. Get a little bit of more harass damage onto Mohoda here. Continues to just pop the press of the attack. Won't have to back up anytime soon, even with the Chen dead. In the end, 1-for-2 going the way of Archon. We can see about 900 gold swinging their way. Gold-wise, we can see the Legion Commander and the Templar Assassin currently leading the board. You know, about 1,000 gold behind for Weaver and this Bulba, Nature's Prophet here. So not off to too terrible of a start. The Templar Assassin did go for damage first with the Desolator, relying on Whitebeard to relocate or to snowball him in, get him in position. And with the Legion Commander, Chen creeps, there's plenty of lockdown to allow the Templar Assassin to get into position. Doesn't need that Blink Dagger just yet. Smoke up from the side of Digital Chaos. They'll head down towards the bottom lane. You can see Mohoda hiding in the woods here. Has a TP scroll ready to go along with the Shadow Blade. We'll pop the Shadow Blade, we'll poke his head out. We'll see Mason here. Won't look to go for a kill, we'll go for a bit of an easier kill on one of these supports if he's able to find them. 1437 will spot Legion Commander on the way out. Resolution moves in, drops the Dream Coil, and Death Ward comes out. And that'll be the death of Legion Commander just as she drops out. Or TP's out, sorry. Make a kill streak going the way of Puck after that one. So we'll see about a 1200 gold swing going the way of Digital Chaos. Another 1700 gold up on this Puck after the Blink Dagger now.
Oh boy, Dire's middle tower.
Resolution Invis standing on top of Chen here, waiting for Bulba to TP in on the side. He'll blink forward.
Dire's middle tower's under attack.
Track comes out from Aoi long range here, and Resolution will orb out and be just fine. Another easy Dire's kill going the way of Digital Chaos. And with the track up, that's 800 gold. Dire Courier goes down in the woods here. Hunting for the Legion Commander, but she TP'd out. Won't be able to find her. Vladimir's Offering comes up for the Brewmaster, and now we see the Blink Dagger completed for the Templar Assassin. Weaver's still working towards the Lincoln Sphere here. Almost has enough money for the Ultimate Orb. Then he's just missing the recipe. Legion Commander has an Ogre Club after completing the Shadow Blade. I'm probably going for a Silver Edge here. Might be the BKB.
Oh, Radiant's top tower is destroyed. Radiant's middle tower is under attack.
Puck spots out the Templar Assassin kind of alone over here. Bulba will start to head over. Blink Dagger is ready to go on the Templar Assassin here. Doesn't look like they want to try to take this fight just yet. Aoi rotates his way in. He really needs that track onto Monkeys Forever here, in case he does pop the meld. Monkeys Forever will just TP out in the woods. Aoi not able to get into position soon enough to make a jump onto this Templar Assassin. Orchid's now completed for Bulba here. He dropped the Ring of Protection in the base. Brewmaster, 1200 gold up after completing the Vladimir's Offering. And looks like he will go for the Black King Bar next. Could be an Agony of Scepter, but most likely the BKB. They will roll through the bottom tier 1 tower, look to make pressure onto the top tier 1. Quick blink forward by the Templar Assassin. Its resolution down to about half HP. Roche will be up in just a minute here. Resolution buys a Ring of Health. I might be looking for a Lincoln Sphere of his own. Brew split on 1437 with the help of those shards. This will be the death of 1437. And Archon will be able to finish off this bottom tier 2 tower as well. Bulba not able to get quite enough damage onto this top tier 2. And get it down to about half HP before the Templar Assassin will TP in and chase it all away. Or kill all the creeps here. He's not going to chase anybody away. Roche will be up in about 30 seconds. Archon in position to take this. And if they just wait a minute, they'll be able to check it. They do have a psionic trap in there, so they'll see it as soon as it pops up. Resolution rolls the orb through just 15 seconds early. Won't spot out the Roche just yet. Bounty Hunter, Buckler up, Arcane Boots up. Be looking to complete the mechanism on Aoi 2000. Chen should have a mech flying out to him, I'd imagine. Yep. Buckler and the Recipe heading out to fluff and stuff. This will be a completed mechanism. Duel on to Resolution is able to finish him off, and another duel goes the way of the Legion Commander. That was his first level 11 duel. Jumping up to 34 victory damage now. With Resolution dead, not really much DC can do about this Roshan here, so they'll let Archon have it. Won't be able to get any trades across the map in the meantime. Brewmaster will TP up top. Whitebeard chasing Aoi 2000. Has the dust ready to go. We'll see if they can sense it out here. Oh, he has a gem on Tusk, so yeah. Nice easy kill, and they're just really waiting out the duel to come up, and another duel going the way of Legion Commander. We'll actually see Legion Commander picking up a Yasha now. Might love to go for an SNY instead of the Silver Edge. Not really much point in a Silver Edge this game. There's not really any passives to disable that are really game-changing. Get rid of that Geminate, but won't really do much. Quick silence onto Jao here. Has the Brew Split up. Won't even need it. Templar Assassin moves in, chases away the puck. Tries to phase shift it out, but Monkeys Forever just waits. SNY now completed. For Legion Commander, we see BKB picked up for Brewmaster. Press the attack on Monkeys Forever, just ripping through this tier 3 tower. Resolution not up for another 20 seconds. Doesn't have the gold for a buyback. Is getting a Lincoln Sphere. Press the attack. Continues to come out for Monkeys Forever. That'll keep him nice and healthy. And this Desolator doing heavy damage to the base of Digital Chaos. Bugs come through trying to stop this here. They'll work through the Refraction Charge. New Refraction will be up in just a couple seconds. Another press the attack comes out. New Refraction comes up. And they're not looking to leave until they get this Lanorax. Resolution now alive, so they'll have to play it a little bit safer. Looks like Archon will back off and not feed a bunch of kills the way of Digital Chaos. Throw out the dream coil onto Muhoda here. Haven't been able to finish him off just yet. Mason's able to finally get the kill onto Muhoda. A 400 gold going his way. Has the Lincoln Sphere completed. Looks like he's working on a BKB now. Oh, we see that's about 1,000 gold going the way of DC with the track kill there. Bounty Hunter still sitting at level 8. Really needs this for a level 11 to really see the gold start rolling in. Weaver will run into Mason in just a second. Mason will run into Fluff and Stuff on this gen here. Geo moving in, has a Primal Split ready to go. They will drop the Sentry Ward, making a go onto Mason here. He'll time lapse out. In the back lines, Tusk is able to pick off Ali 2000, who was lurking. Bulba will head bottom, get as much pushing done as he can here. Unfortunately, he has this Orchid instead of like books or anything else that would help him actually push. We can see now Templar Assassin 2k ahead of Bulba on this Nature's Prophet, 3.5k ahead of this Mason Weaver. Up to 1700 gold on the Weaver. He'll need to save for buyback though, so won't be able to buy any other pieces. 1437 will go down to the Templar Assassin. Wasn't able to get another duel out of that Legion Commander, not quite in position. Brewmaster chasing Mason out of the mid lane here. Shadowblade forward by the Legion Commander. She's hunting for him. Got it. They spot out Ollie with that psionic trap, I believe. Whitebeard has the gem, so as soon as he arrives, they'll easily be able to kill off Ali. Looks like they will group up and look to get a little bit of damage onto this melee Rax. He's already at half HP. Nice press the attack. They could probably work through this Rax fairly quickly. Here's a press the attack. Orb forward by resolution. Dreamcoil's ready to go. Doesn't decide to jump in. BKB up for the Brewmaster. Still sitting on the split. Doesn't need it just yet. Able to take out the mid lane of Rax. Pops a Primal Split as he gets down to about half HP, and will be able to back up safely. 1200 gold up for Muhoda after this SNY Shadowblade. Smoke up from the side of DC, trying to catch up to this Chen. Unfortunately, they don't have a track on the Chen, so they're a little bit slower than they really should be. Tusk blinks away. No, he didn't blink away. Don't know where the Tusk went. See the duel come out on to Mason from Muhoda here. Not able to finish off Mason in time, unfortunately. Death Ward rolling out. That will kill the Legion Commander as he breaks the Dream Coil. So far, a 1-for-1. Only Theban down right now. Templar Assassin able to pick off this Bulba Nature's Prophet. So in the end, a 2-for-1 going the way of DC. That was a track kill on the Legion Commander. So it should be a decent amount of gold going the way of Nature's Prophet. Check the fight recap here. Actually gains about 32 gold after that engagement. But we see another 600 gold showing up on the Templar Assassin, who is now a solid 4k ahead of the Weaver, 3k ahead of this Nature's Prophet. Bulba picks up the Maelstrom, just looking to get the cheapest split pushing item he can. That'll give him a little bit of wave clear to help deal with this mid as well. See Aoi and Mason chasing the Templar Assassin. Monkeys Forever sniffs it out, blinks away. Moonshard, Crystallis, Desolator up on this Templar Assassin. She would likely destroy Aoi 2000 before he's able to actually kill her with Mason. That would have been a bad engagement if they had taken that one. Muhoda, Fluff, and Whitebeard will move through the jungle, look to hook up with Monkeys Forever, and likely just go kill Mason here. Another piece of the BKB completed. 60 gold short of the buyback. There's the money for buyback. Shadowblade forward by Legion Commander here. Chen will break the Lincoln Sphere. Muhoda will move in with the duel. Not able to kill him in time for the duel damage, but they are able to kill him nonetheless with the Tusk punch stopping any sort of time lapse. So Mason decides he needs the BKB, not buyback. Archon not really in a position to go for a trade here. We'll see the Templar Assassin go down. Puck actually survives through that. So a great kill going the way of DC with that one. We see 900 gold showing up for 1437 after that one. 1800 gold up on the Switch Doctor. We'll see if he wants to grab another support item or if he does want to go for a Aghanim Scepter. Brewmaster, 3,500 gold up now after completing this BKB Blink Dagger Vladimir's Offering. We'll see what he wants to get next. Could go for something like an Assault Cuirass, but I think... Nope. So the Tusk finished a Lotus Orb. Brewmaster could definitely get an AC. Could get something like a Sheepish Guard. Could get a Sheep Stick. Really anything would be acceptable. If he wants to help the team the most, an AC probably. Chen, Mech, Arcane Boots, Point Booster, just working towards that Aghanim Scepter. Mason, running in behind here, has the BKB ready to go. JO blinks forward, will destroy Aoi with the help of a Test of Faith coming out from Fluff and Stuff. Roshan is now respawned. I imagine DC will put up a little bit of a fight for this one. See the Templar Assassin actually up in the top lane, split pushing 2,700 gold up on her. Next piece of the Aghanim Scepter comes out for Chen. Just 1,800 gold short. We'll send Muhoda home. Monkeys Forever rotating over towards the Roche pit here. We might see a smoke come out. Yeah, there's the smoke from Fluff. So they'll probably either head straight into the Roche pit or they'll cut up through the Ancients of Digital Chaos here. Resolution, Ghost Scepter up, Ultimate Orb up after this Lincoln Sphere. Just working on a Sheep Stick for right now. They saw the orb roll through. Once the orb popped, they ran into the pit. Unfortunately, Fluff had half of his creeps outside of the pit, and they're able to spot that out. Chen goes down right away to start a fight. Quick turnaround kill onto Aoi here. Resolution doing heavy damage onto Whitebeard. Lotus Orb up. Hasn't quite been able to finish off Whitebeard just yet. Brewmaster's able to pick off the Witch Doctor. So far, 2 for 2. All the support's dead for either team. We'll see Bulba head home. Resolution on the way out, should be able to escape Monkeys Forever here. Another blink forward would catch him, but doesn't have it for another 6 seconds. Mason headed to the bottom to split push the best he can here. Doesn't have the BKB for another 40 seconds. But Muhoda does not have a way to break this Lincoln Sphere, so all he can do is really right click. Monkeys Forever and J.O. did head into the Roche Pit. They'll finish that off before Resolution sniffed it out. Mason running in, he'll spot out the Templar Assassin carrying a Cheese and an Aegis of the Mortal. This is definitely not a fight they want to take. Monkeys Forever going to do heavy damage before they get anywhere close. Actually pops the Cheese already a little bit early. See Muhoda down to 200 HP. A couple last right clicks will come in. That'll be the death of the Legion Commander. Templar Assassin blinking back in will blow up Aoi 2000. Mason and Resolution jump forward there. Resolution actually continued to jump onto the other side of the fight. Monkeys Forever still has the Aegis ready to go. Kills off the Witch Doctor. Mason and Resolution re-engaging. Resolution dropping the Dream Coil, doing heavy damage. Not able to do anything with that, actually. And we'll see Templar Assassin pick off Bulba on the back of that fight. Resolution on the way out, 2200 gold up on him. A little bit short of that Scythe of Vice. Needs to save for buyback at this point, though. So Bulba down for another 40 seconds. Unfortunately, the creep wave on the bottom is all the way up at the tier 3s. Of Archon, so they won't really be able to turn this into a push at all. None of the lanes were in their favor. Jail will head down to the bottom, work on pushing this out. Templar Assassin working her way towards the top lane. Recipe for the Daedalus just needs to go by the Demon Edge. Brewmaster does pick up the Assault Cuirass, as I mentioned earlier. Just trying to stack on as much minus armor as possible. And the additional armor will help versus the right clicks coming out from Mason. Goes for a Demon Edge now. Probably going to pick up the MKB to help deal with the Drunken Haze that keeps being sprayed onto him by the Brewmaster. Owie has a Staff of Wizardry up now. Probably just looking to go for a 4-staff, a little bit more escape. Might run into Muhoda here. Doesn't look like anything will come of that. Mithril Hammer, Order Club up for the Legion Commander. Should be picking up a BKB of her own now. Owie still Fluff and Stuff still 1400 gold short of the Aghanim Scepter. Boots of Travel actually come up from the Templar Assassin now. We'll start to see this Templar Assassin bounce all over the map, always showing up for the fights. We'll pretty much always have a TP into the fight with the Chen, providing plenty of TP targets. Game has gone into a bit of a lull here. We see Templar Assassin leading by 4k gold. Still has the Aegis, 1000 gold. Mason making a bit of a go. But that'll almost cost Mason his life. Just barely able to get that time lapse off for the last killing blow. Probably would have landed there. Another crit would have done him in. Oh, he has a TP here. He's just kind of hiding in the woods right now. Muhoda and Whitebeard trying to scout this out, figure out where the heck Owie is. They haven't seen him in a while. They must think he's over here, though. They're doing a lot of searching in the woods. Bulba completed the Molmir now. Bit of a different build on this Nature's Prophet, but it will allow Bulba to push waves and de-push with all the chain lightnings coming out. Bulba will head back to the top lane and pop some Mulmir on himself in case anybody shows up and tries to go on him. It just pushes up as much as he can. Only an outer or tier 2 remaining for the side of Archon. We'll see Templar Assassin TP back to the top lane to stop the push. BKB up and ready to go for this Legion Commander, saving another 300 gold after that. Tusk, 2000 gold up on him. Gem, Lotus Orb, probably picks up a Blink Dagger next. Smoke comes out from the side of Archon. They'll run through the mid, heading up towards Theban and Bulba here. Bulba will be able to TP out whenever he wants, and the Witch Doctor has a TP as well. Be a quick dual death for 1437 here. Whitebeard rolling in. And Bulba will TP out on top of that. Jao hunting for Mason in the woods. Looks like they'll turn this into a push on the top. Still have an outer tower up here for DC that Archon can easily clean up with the Witch Doctor dead. They'll use the Frozen Sigil to spot out the ward. Blink Dagger does come up from the Tusk, as expected. And now we see Bulba go down to the Templar Assassin, who was hiding down bot. Resolution will start to head over here with Owie. Has the Scythe of Ice ready to go. 700 gold short of the Blink Dagger, making an all-in play, being this far out by himself here. But we see four players of Archon up top. Working on this top tier 2, and we'll see the Templar Assassin TP in.
Dire's top tower's under attack. Dire's top tower's fallen.
BKB comes out for this Templar Assassin now. She'll be rather hard to deal with refraction charges, and the press the attack should rip through this tier 3 tower fairly quickly. Jao blinking on to Jao. Archon blinking on 1437 prompts the primal split underneath the BKB. He'll break the Lincoln Spear of Mason, throw him up in the air, and head back to hitting buildings. Monkeys Forever just purely focused on objectives at this point. Resolution blinks forward, drops the sheep. Sheep will get canceled off by the Lotus Orb, however. Resolution still alive for the moment, pops the ghost up to live. Monkeys Forever will pop a quick duel on to Bulba, and that'll be the game. Not quite a full team wipe for Archon at the end here. Just Resolution alive, but a decently fast game for Archon, showing their dominance throughout pretty much the entire game. They've been ahead. We look at the graphs quick here. Yeah, game's been in Archon's favor ever since about the 10-minute mark. So no